What's up everyone, I'm Mike, and welcome back to the ICO Investor Channel, and today we're going to talk and compare the Ledger and Trezor. But before we start, please notice our disclaimer. Since I am not a financial advisor, this video is for informational and educational purposes only, so without further ado, let's begin to our topic. Trezor and Ledger are two of the world's premier manufacturers of crypto hardware wallets. Trezor was the first hardware wallet ever created, and the Ledger Nano X is among the most popular, because it has sold over 1 million units worldwide. Hardware wallet, like those made by Trezor and Ledger, also provide a way for users to bring their wallet online, send and receive transaction, so well in the case of Ledger. One thing that I want to mention is that users can also trade cryptocurrencies inside the Ledger Live app now. Let's quickly compare both of them to understand which one is better for your needs. Both wallets made by both the companies are designed for beginners and advanced users. To get set up, it involves very simple steps. You have to create a wallet, backup seed phrase, PIN for the device, and both apps kind of make the process as simple as possible. And users are guided along every step of the way, and let your wallets include. Additional step of installing the Ledger Live app, which can be downloaded and installed like any other app, and it includes a built-in crypto exchange, where users can trade different currencies in terms of security. Both Trezor and Ledger are hardware wallet that hold crypto in cold storage, which means that coins are kept offline where they are safest from the hackers. And to provide additional security, Ledger uses secure element chip, and these are the same chips that used in your passports, SIM card, credit card, and similar devices. And Ledger wallets are also evaluation assurance level 5, plus rated. And EIL is basically an increasing scale of universally recognized security standards for software or hardware products, and there are different degrees of EIL. There are only two levels higher than L5, and the company claims are the same chips that are used in your passports, SIM card, credit card, and similar devices. And Ledger wallets are also evaluation assurance level 5 plus rated, and EIL is basically an increasing scale of universally recognized security standards for software or hardware products. And there are different degrees of EIL. There are only two levels higher than L5, and the company claims that the only company that makes the hardware wallet with this level of security certification. In terms of features, both the wallets have a display screen, although Trezor's screens are a bit larger, and it can display additional lines of text. And those who struggle to read fine print may prefer a Trezor wallet any day. For Ledger, most of the actions that users take happen in the app. Basically, the mytrezor.com web-based interface or the Trezor app for Android will be required to use a Trezor wallet. The Ledger wallets normally have a smaller screen. It doesn't support color. The Ledger text also scrolls across the screen slowly to accommodate for the smallest size, whereas the Trezor screen is large enough to kind of like show 6 lines of text simultaneously. The Ledger Nano S supports 1100 different currency. The Trezor One supports 1000 currency, and it's logical to assume that there's a plenty of overlap. However, one notable exception is XRP. Trezor does not have a support for XRP, but Ledger does, and new users who are looking to trade Ethereum or one of the many popular ACK20 token might prefer Ledger wallets, in my opinion, and that's because Ledger wallets, you can interact with these tokens without any additional steps that are required by wallet users, and Trezor normally supports over 1000 currencies, but to use ETH and many ACK20 tokens built top the Ethereum network requires a third-party wallet software like MetaMask and stuff like that. In terms of price, the price of a basic model of a Trezor and Ledger wallet is very identical. The Ledger Nano would cost you $59 before the shipping cost, and the Trezor One would cost you $60, and the more expensive models they have is the Ledger Nano X and the Trezor model, which cost $119 and $187 respectively. So overall, I would like to say that both of these Trezor and Ledger offer affordable wallet options that support a larger selection of cryptocurrencies. While Ledger is an EIL 5 plus rated, it has a sleeker design, has an app that can be used straight to crypto. Trezor offers like a larger screen, it's easier to use and supports more frequent rate, and works with a web-based interface. And that's all for the comparison of Ledger and Trezor. Come visit our channel, subscribe, and watch out for our next videos here at ICO Investor. Thank you for watching.